Okay, let us do the full screen. So today's date is 23/7/20. Classwork number, I think it is classwork number 16. Okay, we will check again. So let's start some question from exercise 4.2. Exercise 4.2, question 1 is saying give the first step to separate the variable and then solve the equation. Okay, so let us try the F part. It is saying, sorry, let's take the E part. Y minus 4 equal to minus 7. All of you, what is the first step in this? Please tell, what is the first step? What is the first step? Add. All of you, please tell. We can add 4 on both sides, Banipreet. Good, beta. So the first step, we have to understand that we have minus 4 over here. We have to understand we have minus 4 on the left hand side. We want to remove this. We want to remove this. So what will we do? We will add 4 on both sides. First step. Yes, beta, it is same, Lavya. Adding, subtracting and inverse is same thing, because actually 4 is inverse of minus 4. Okay. So when you add, what will happen? Y minus 4 plus 4. Rishi, if you do transpose method, you will not be able to correctly give the answer of this one. Okay. It is equal to minus 7 plus 4. Now these two will cancel. Y is equal to minus 3. Now the answer is Y equal to minus 3 only. So we have done the first step, and in the first step itself, we got the answer. Okay. Now let's take one more example. These are all very easy. I'm giving you from my side. Yes, beta. Inverse of division is multiplication. Inverse of division is multiplication. Okay. Let us take question number 2 now. Give the first step you will use to separate the variable. Now take P upon 7 is equal to 4. That is C part. All of you, in this case, we have 7. In this case, we have 7 in division. What will we do? Today my connection is unstable. Are you all able to hear me? Are you all able to see me and hear me? Please confirm. Please confirm. Class. No, sir. Okay, now I think it is okay. Let us see. Voice is cracking a little bit. Okay. Could you please tell me if transforming method, the answer would be correct or wrong? Beta, both will be correct. Okay. Now see, in this case, we can see 7 is extra over here. What will we do in the first step? We will multiply both sides. Multiply both side by 7. So we will get P upon 7 multiplied by 7 is equal to 4 into 7. So these two 7 will cancel each other and we'll get the answer as 28. Okay. It depends in the exam which method is asked. If method is not asked from the examiner, you can use any method. Both are correct. Okay. You can use any method of your choice. Now, let us take one more part. Let's take F part. Is subtraction having any inverse? But it's very simple. Inverse of subtraction is I know beta, today some issues there in my internet, I guess. Voice is cracking. Okay. Voice is cracking. Beta, don't know what is happening today. Okay, don't worry. Sir, it is okay now. Sai, she is saying. Now, let's start. We have, suppose, E part. In the E part, we have 8y is equal to 36. All of you, please tell, it is because of rain, maybe. Now, please tell me, what will you do? Sarvagya is saying he wants to take a screenshot. Sarvagya, beta, you can take from that YouTube also, na? Don't worry. Please tell me, what will we do? Divide both sides by... eight. So we will get 8y upon 8 is equal to 36 upon 8. It will be cancelled and answer is 36 upon 8. We all know it is not a proper fraction. Not. It is a improper. So you can change also if you want. Sir, how can we take screenshot on laptop? Lavya, you can press the window button. Sorry, the start button. You can press the start button. Keep pressing it and press PRTSC on the top. Press window button and PRTSC. You will have your screenshots. Okay. No issue, beta Rishi. Correct. Now, let's take one more example. Suppose we take H part. Sir, your voice is cracking so much in between. Sir, can we take improper fraction as decimal? You can take beta. It is compulsory to convert in mixed fraction. It is not compulsory, but it is your responsibility. If you know something, you should do. Beta, some are saying not cracking, some are saying cracking. I don't know why it is happening. Some are saying I am audible. That means issues are less from my side. Okay. Let's see. H part 20t is equal to minus 10. All of you tell me what will we do? Divide both sides by 20. So we will get 20t upon 20 is equal to minus 10 upon 20. 20, 20 cancel and we will get here 1 upon 2 and answer is t equal to minus 1 upon 2. Okay. Now let's take question number 3. Question number 3. Beta, if it is cracking, I cannot do much in this. Sir, I didn't understand. Please go up. One second. In this question, what we did is we had 20t is equal to minus 10. If you observe, this 20 is extra over here. This 20 is multiplying with t. So we will divide both sides by 20. This is the first step, that is 20t upon 20. Beta Kritika, I will take that also. Please switch off your video. Minus 10 upon 20. So this will cancel. This become 1 upon 2. T is equal to minus 1 upon 2. Ryan, is it okay now? Ryan, is it okay now? Abhas, I cannot do anything if you are not able to hear me. I cannot do anything. Sir, can't we divide both sides by 10? बेटा रियान, इफ यू डिवाइड बाय 10, व्हाट विल हैपन इज यू विल स्टिल हैव 2 लेफ्ट ओवर हियर. रियान, डोंट डिवाइड विद 10, ओनली डिवाइड विद 20. ओके, नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, गिव द स्टेप्स टू सेपरेट द वेरिएबल एंड सॉल्व द इक्वेशन. लेट्स टेक ए पार्ट. 3n-2 is equal to 46. All of you, please tell what should be the first step. What should be the first step? Please answer. What should be the first step? Please answer. What should be the first step? Add 2 on both sides. So you can see here we have -2 on the left hand side. So we will take inverse of it. That is, we will add 2 on both sides. What will we get? 3n-2+2 is equal to 46+2. These two will cancel. We will have 3n is equal to 48. Now, what will we do? As you can see, 3 is extra over here and it is multiplying. Inverse of multiply is divide. Yes, so we will divide both sides. Divide both side by 3. We will get is equal to 48/3. It becomes 1. So answer is n is equal to 48/3. And the answer is 3 ones are 3, 3 sixes are 18. Beta Banipreet, it is same thing that I have told you. You can do by any method. I'm repeating one more time. First, we saw we have -2 on the left hand side. We want to remove it. To remove it, what I have done is I have added 2 on both the sides. It becomes +2 here, +2 here. So these two cancelled. We got 3n equal to 48. After this, we have this 3 extra over here. So I divide both sides by 3. I get 3n/3 equal to 48/3. 3 and 3 cancel. Answer is 48/3, which is 3 ones are 6 are 48. Now, if you do by transpose method, sir, why did you cut 2 and 2? Beta, -2+2. Beta, the person who was asking why I cut -2 and +2, because -2+2 equal to 0. Simple. That is why I have cut them. Okay. If you don't want, no need. Sir, why do we have variable? Okay. Okay. But sir, by transposing, what will be the first step? Okay. Please understand one thing. There are 90 students. I cannot answer everyone like this. Please ask which is genuine. Sir, can't we use the division process in the above question? Okay, Daksh is asking the story. But we will discuss someday, huh? Don't worry. Okay. Let us take one more part. C part. 20p/3 is equal to 40. All of you, yes, we have to remove extra numbers to find the variable. Yes, Vivan, correct. So you can see here p is the variable. First of all, we will try to remove this 3. This 3 is here in division. This 3 is here in division. So we will have to multiply 3 both the sides. So multiply 3 on both sides. It becomes into 3 is equal to 40 into 3. Now 3 ones are 3. 3 is gone. Now what is left? 20 is left. So for 20, it is multiplying over here. We have to divide. Divide 20 both sides. We get 20p upon 20 is equal to 40 into 3 upon 20. Cancelled. 20 twos are 40. Answer is 6. If you solve by transposing method, in that case, finding steps will be difficult. Let me show you how. In transposing, what we do? First, we transfer the 3 to right side. It becomes 40 into 3. Second step, we write this 20 will go in division. Like this, 20 twos are, answer is 6 only. So in the question, if steps are asked, sir, can we directly do 120 by 20? You can do better, no issue. It is my, what you say, choice. Yes, transposing is easy, but when you want to say the steps, what is the first step? What is the second step? In that case, inverse method is easy, because to tell the steps, you have to go for inverse method. Please don't switch on your videos in between. Please stop your video. Okay. Himanshi, please, for what, beta? You can name it as a transport also, no issue. Now, please repeat first. What first, beta? C part, Himanshi. First question. Question 1, that is 4.2 question 1 you are saying. Himanshi, beta, you can see that in the lecture, in the YouTube channel, okay? Okay. So please send the link for response today. Now see, one more part. Question number 4. In question 4, we have to solve the following questions. In this case, nothing is written. So you can try any way. If you want inverse way, do with that. If you want transpose way, do with that. Okay. Beta Mehak, I will send. Is the class over right now? Why are you asking right now? Mehak, don't you want to study? Don't ask unnecessary question in between, please. Let us take B part. It is 10p plus 10 equal to 100. I will solve by both the way. I will solve by both the way. First, let us do by inverse way. In this case, the question is 10p plus 10 equal to 100. First, we will get rid of 10. First, we will get rid of 10. So we will subtract 10 from both sides. We will get 10p plus 10 minus 10 equal to 100 minus 10. It becomes 10p is equal to 90. Now we want to get rid of this 10. We want to get rid of this 10. What will we do? We will, all of you, divide both sides by 10. The answer will be 10p upon 10 is equal to 90 upon 10. 10, 10 cancel. 10 9s are 90. So answer is 9. Now let's do with second method, that easy one. In this case also, but I will do, Rishi, G part I will do, don't worry. 10p is equal to 100 minus 10. I have taken 10 to the right side, to the 10 has crossed the border. Now this 10 will cross, but before that solve it, 90. Now 10 will cross the border. Here it is multiplying. On the right side it will divide. So answer is 9. So you are free to use any method in this question 4. But in the previous questions, it was asking the steps. So for steps, you need to go for inverse method. Okay. Now let's take G part. Let's take, okay, you are saying D part. Let me take D part also. D part is very easy. Let us take. It is saying minus P by 3 is equal to 5. We want to find the value of P. Let's find first by inverse method. First of all, class, tell me, what will you do? First step will be, please tell, multiply both side by 3. Very good. First, we will multiply both side by 3. We will get minus P by 3 into 3 is equal to 5 into 3. We get minus P is equal to 15. Now, what should we do? Have we got the answer? Have we got the answer? One more step is remaining. All of you, have we got the answer? No, we have not got the answer. We have not got the answer. One more step is there. We want value of P, not minus P. We want value of P, not minus P. So what should we do? What should we do? Yes, class, how can we find the value of P? Please tell, what should I multiply both the sides? What should I multiply both the sides? Multiply minus 1 both the sides. Very good, Tushita. To remove the negative sign, I will multiply both sides by minus 1. I will get P is equal to minus 15. I hope it is clear to everyone. We wanted to find the value of P, not minus P. Now, let's do by transfer method. Okay. Do you know? I can write this as this also. Can you please tell me, are these two things same? Whether I keep negative sign above or below, is it different? No, it is not different. It is same. If I say 2 upon 1 or if I say 2 upon minus 1, they are same. They are same. Okay. So now I will take this minus 3 to the right side. Why they are same? Because it is a rule. P equal to 5 into minus 3. Answer is minus 15. Whether you keep negative sign numerator or in the denominator, it is same thing. Okay. Answer will remain same only. Now let's take one more part. Please tell in which part you have doubt. Please tell in which part you have doubt. Sir, explain once again, inverse one. In E part. Okay, I'm telling again. First, let me revise this. D part again. Please see again. D part. We had P minus P upon 3 is equal to 5. So, first thing is, we want to get rid of 3. It is in division over here. So we will multiply both side by 3. It becomes minus P is equal to 5 into 3. Then we multiply both side by minus 1. Minus 1. It becomes minus 1 into minus P is equal to 15 into minus 1. We know when there are two negatives multiplying, it becomes positive and answer is minus 15. Now let's take C part. Beta Sarvagya, what is in the C part? Multiply 4 with 5. Nothing is there. Let's take E part. In the E part, we have 3P upon 4 equal to 6. Now, all of you, so why didn't we multiply minus p with 3? Why? But you can check again, it was in division, that's why I multiplied with it to remove it. So from where minus 1 came? Beta, were you sleeping when I was telling it? Please see again. Now, in this case, we have to first remove this 4. We have to first remove this 4. We should multiply with 4. Multiply 4 on both sides. What will we get? First step. Now 4 ones are 4. 4 is gone. Now we will try to remove the 3. Yes, Banipreet, correct. Class, please tell, how will you remove this 3? How will you remove this 3? Divide by 3, yes. Divide 3 on both sides. Now 3 ones are 3. We can solve it now. 3 twos are 6 and answer is p equal to 8. All of you got the answer? English statement of part E. English statement very simple. 3 times p divided by 4 is 6. You can write this as, if you want to write, 3 times p divided by 4 is 6. Okay. Now let's take one more part. Last one. Let's take I part. 2q plus 6 is equal to 12. G part you are saying. Okay. Let's take G part. G part is 3s plus 12 equal to 0. All of you, first we will try to solve by inverse method, then we will solve by normal method. So we all know 12 is extra over here. It is in positive. So we will subtract 12 from both sides. Subtract 12 from both sides. We will get 3s plus 12 minus 12 equal to 0 minus 12. So it will be 3s is equal to minus 12. Now what will we do? This 3 is extra over here. What shall we do? Class, we should divide by 3 on both side. It becomes 3, 3 cancel. 3 4s are, so answer is s equal to minus 4. I hope you got this. Yes, class. Now, next method, very simple. Same way, we will take the 12 to right hand side. It becomes 0 minus 12. That is 3 is equal to minus 12. Now, this 3 will come here in division. And answer is again minus 12. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now it is your choice. If you want by transpose method, you can do by that also or by this one also. So inverse is required when you have to tell the steps. Okay. Now open your videos.